Well, the first thing you should do is put in perspective. And it's a pool tournament. There's billions of people who couldn't give less of a shit about it. Seriously, nobody cares. Now, I think what gets most players reluctant to enter is the fear of not knowing what to do when getting in a situation of just doing the wrong thing and the feeling of incompetence. They're just making a fool of themselves. Some of the old school players get into these tournaments just to play bad, knock them off so they can get action. So understand that the railbirds talking shit about you is going to get you more action if that's the kind of player you are. So what I mean is some players get real nervous at tournaments and they're not nervous at all when they're gambling. So, you know, it can work for you to play bad in a tournament that people are watching. No legitimate pool player is going to look down on you for entering a tournament where you might be in over your head a little bit, like a pro open tournament. You had the balls to get in, and that says a lot about your heart and your desire to be a great pool player, because that's, you know, you're going to take your lumps, and that's what it takes, that guts. There is no great gutless pool player. It takes a lot of guts. That the most important match for you is the first one, because a lot of your nervousness, if you win the first match, will dissipate. Your confidence will go up and you'll worry less. It'll take the weight of the world off your shoulders if you just win that first match. And every match that you win afterward will do more of that. It'll further, you know, decrease that weight on your shoulders. Now, if you get, like, really unlucky and draw shame in your first match, and you actually get a chance to shoot, when that match is over, I look up to Shannon and ask him what he thinks that you need to work on. And his answer is going to be worth the entry fee of the tournament. And listen to him and believe him. As for the railbirds, not all of them are going to be pulling against you. But there is going to be a lot of them, and number one, they're not going to be paying attention to your match until the second half of the tournament. But they're there to lick everyone's boots and get his autograph, get their picture taken. So, yeah, slightest bit of attention to you. But, you know, word gets around real quick. And if that's what you're worried about, then go back and remind yourself that these are the people that didn't have the balls to get in the tournament, okay? So you're 1,000 steps ahead of these people just by mustering the courage to get in. They let their fear hold them back and you didn't. That's huge. I mean, that's like almost everything. So, it does take a little bit of anger, even if you have to muster it up in yourself. This is why you'll notice that beneath the surface there is a little bit of anger in the best pool players in the world. And you'll see that if you ever get to spend some time with them. The little trolls on AZ Billiards Forum, these people have made me more money than any group of people in the world. So, you know, if they're talking shit about you, let them talk. what's going to prove yourself is your actions, not your words. What's going to prove yourself is your progress, your guts, your heart, and you're just your determination to not give up, to not let your fear get in your way. That's courage. Shot was admittedly a mistake. I didn't take a good enough look at the two-ball line and wound up getting on the right side of the two-ball line when I wanted to be on the left-hand side. So now I have to go forward into the seven-ball in hopes that that seven-ball doesn't get in my way when I'm shooting a three, and it doesn't. So now it's all about getting back in line and getting right on four, five, and six. Don't announce it. Don't even tell your spouse or your best friend. Just quietly show up somewhere, put down your money. Tell them your name is whatever name you can think of, and go ahead and proceed to do what you do, man. Now, if you do real good, or you wind up winning the dang thing, they're going to find out your real name is not Ephraim Van Boning, but that's okay. You can deal with that later. You got a whole bunch more money in your pocket, and world is good. I got a pisser. That was almost an emergency, and I had to borrow some guy's driveway to take care of that emergency. Good God Almighty. Thing that happens when you get old, man. Yeah, you just ain't gonna hold it for too long. It's just something you gotta deal with in life. When I'm out here doing this, I always know where the construction sites are, where the convenience stores are, how far away from them I am. If I gotta pee, man. Is it not Jesus? And the tournament director comes over to you and questions you. You can tell them you're at the players' meeting and you didn't hear any policy against using the name Jesus. You could do that. Go ahead and listen to them. Also remind them that many of the world's greatest players used fake names for years and years and years. They still do. And that includes Mr. Efren. Yep, Mr. Efren. So, you know, if they're paying in cash, then you shouldn't have to worry about it. Now, if they're paying in check, you're going to have to tell them your real name so you can deposit that check. But most tournaments are all cash. Either way, it won't be a big deal. Don't sweat it too much. And this will take the pressure off you, some of the pressure. You're going to put self-imposed pressure on yourself. But really, folks, no one gives a rat's ass about this tournament. I mean, you really got to put it in perspective. You do, of course, and that's great. But it's not like millions of people are sitting around watching you and wanting you to make a mistake. If anything, if you're really an unknown player, most people love an underdog, so they'll be pulling for you. They want to see you do well. Not everyone is an easy billiards gossip and little prick. There are some cool people out there, so don't just stop sweating. And I know that's easier said. But really, it does help to take as much pressure off yourself as you possibly can. And then you can look at it as self-imposed, unnecessary. picking up on some of my work I did a couple months ago, and everything is looking groovy. I always check up on the work if there's any problems. Sometimes I experiment, kind of push the boundaries of the things I do. Yeah, no, I'm not going to tell you what I do. And they become a little bit iffy, and I think, well, I can always fix this. Because chances are good, my customers won't call me back and say, hey, come fix it. A lot of times I can't even see that it could be a problem. But I always do this. I always do this when things are just a little iffy. It's either, going to be a lasting work of art or not. And I don't mind breaking a code or two to keep my people happy. Marianne always has this incredibly huge crush, this romantic thing for Gilligan. Yeah, she likes Gilligan a lot. So Gilligan could have gotten Marianne any dang time he wanted to, but he didn't. He never did because his confidence was not high enough. So don't sit in some poor room for 30 years trying to become the flawless god of pulling boogers, because no one is ever the flawless god of pulling boogers. No one. Never. It doesn't happen. It's a myth. So what I'm trying to say is don't be the Gilligan of pool. You don't want to wind up a grumpy old man who can't hold his pee. Just to say goodbye, I'm done, I'm over, I'm gonna die. Don't do that, Jesus. Yeah, I don't know if you read Jason Shaw's book. Secrets of Jason Shaw. But one of the things he confesses about is loving to rack up the poobles. He loves to rack. So take Jason aside and have a little talk with him. And make him your little rack boy. That's what you gotta do, like I'm about to do to the world famous James Lewis. Make them your way. serious traffic jam. And I saw this on the way to where I was going, but I figured they'd have it all cleared up by now. And I was wrong again. When people get really nervous and for some reason they stop breathing, yeah, it's really odd. Which just increases their nervousness. So you should be conscious of that and actually remind yourself to breathe, as silly as that sounds. Because that's what they do. I don't know if it's something in our genetic makeup or what. But yeah, we stop breathing. And that decreases the oxygen to your brain. And makes it difficult to think clearly. In fact, it makes it impossible. It brings out the panic instinct, you know? The need to survive thing. And it stops a lot of players in their tracks just because they're not conscious of the fact that they're not breathing. Yeah, it's a very odd thing. So don't just, you know, remind yourself to breathe. Take some really deep breaths. And that should help some of your nervousness subside a little bit, enough to catch your bearings and put it in perspective. And it takes a while for the brain to figure out that we're hungry, we need food. So in that time, a lot of damage can be done, and when we're hungry, emotions tend to get away from us and creates more room for unnecessary nervousness. So yeah, eat a lot. Eat a big breakfast, big lunch, big dinner, and keep eating even after you've had your fill. Just make sure your body's not going to get hungry, particularly at the start or during any part of a match. Don't drink too much. I've seen players drink all through playing tournaments and play very well until they've just had one too many, and then they get sloppy and they blow it. So particularly the night before, it's really hard to play pool when we're hungover. It's really difficult. So yeah, don't drink too much. And drinking is a common method of, you know, relaxing our nerves and stuff. And the problem is it works. But if you're out drinking all the night before to calm your nerves, it's going to be counterproductive the following day when you have a pool match, because your body's all screwed up. So a shot right before the match can help you, can help your nerves a lot. But then people make the mistake of thinking, well, if that helped me, then two shots is even better, and that's where they make their mistake and they go over the line. You get good at pool by practicing and working on your weak spots, analyzing your game, really